with the Reverend Gary Davis, who liked me. And I wrote this next song, and he started using me as his opening act. I mean, I was 14, you know, I thought, wow, that was easy. Then this guy came up and said, kid, I'm going to make you a star. And next thing I knew, a couple of weeks later, I was in the recording studio, and I thought, wow, that was easy. Then the record came out. Murray the K went on it. WRFM had just started. And they went on it, so I had a hit record in New York, and I thought, wow, how cool am I? This is a recurring theme with artists like myself who are generally very self-obsessed. It's the how cool am I? More me is always a good thing. So this record comes out, and it's about a black boy dating a white girl. And before I know it, half the United States is screaming at me. And I found myself writing about this episode where I was on a stage in Encino, California. There were about 2,200 people in the crowd. And all was going well, and then I got to this next song, and I got to the chorus, and from somewhere right around here in the center right there, somebody yelled out, "Nigger lover, get off the stage!" Well, I was 15 at the time. I thought, well, okay, that's an opinion, I guess. And then two or three people started yelling it. And before I knew it, I had 20 people chanting it at me. And they started to drown out the guitar, and they started to drown out the voice, and they started to move toward the stage. And I didn't want anybody to see me in tears, but I started to cry. So I put down the guitar, and I tried to calmly walk off the stage. And I made it into the wings, and then went racing for the ladies' room, where I just put my head over the sink and cried a river. The promoter came running in. And he said, why did you leave the stage? What's the matter with you? And I said, where have you been? And he said, I've been in the box office counting money, of course. I said, well, I guess it doesn't matter much to you then. He said, you can't do this. You can't walk off a stage in the middle of a show. And I said, you know what? They were screaming at me. They were screaming all kinds of things at me, and I didn't know what to do. I mean, I don't know if I let them keep screaming. Nobody was doing anything. So I left, and he said, well, you have to go back. And I looked at him, and I said, I can't go back there. I can't go back there. Those people are crazy. They might hurt me. I can't go back on stage. And he said something to me that has stood me in good stead ever since. He said, look, if those people drive you off a stage tonight, what's going to happen the next time somebody says something they don't like? They're going to come back with even more people, and they're going to drive them off the stage. And that's going to keep happening until one day we're living in a country where there's no room for people like you or me. Somebody's got to stop. Somebody's got to take a stand. You know, and I thought about it, and I thought about it, and in retrospect, now that I'm an adult and I understand business a bit better, in retrospect, he just didn't want to have to give everyone back their money. But at the time, it seemed like a particularly noble thing to say to me. So I went back on stage, and the chanting started again. And I picked up the guitar, and I just started to sing the song. And I ignored them. And son of a gun, if as I ignored them and just kept singing, the audience took matters into their own hands. And people in the surrounding seats got up and walked over to them and started telling them to shut up. And then every usher in the theater had gotten together, and they all came marching down the aisle, shining their flashlights on these people and telling them to leave. And as I watched them leave, I realized that at the end of the day, they were cowards. Because they didn't walk out with their heads up. I mean, I was standing there singing with my head up. They didn't walk out with their heads up. They walked out slinking, like they were ashamed of what they had just done. And I thought, son of a gun, Woody Guthrie and Pete Seeger have on their instruments, "This machine kills fascists." Who knew that they were so graphically correct in that? Come to my door. Face as clean and shining black as night. My mama went to auntie, you know that you looked so fine. Now I could understand the tears and the shame. She called you boy instead of your name. When she wouldn't let you inside, when she turned and said, but honey, he's not our kind. She said, I can't see you anymore, baby. I can't see you anymore. Walk me down to school, baby. Everybody's acting deaf and blind. Until they turn and say, why don't you just stick to your own kind? My teachers all laugh, they're smirking stares, cutting deep down in our affairs. Preachers of equality, high. One of these days I'm gonna raise up my glistening wings and fly. But that day will have to wait for a while. Baby, I'm only society's child. When we're older, things may change, but for now, see you anymore. No, I-